It's not a comfortable subject. It's not something people want to spend time thinking about. If you're a circumcised man, it's definitely not something you want to think about. And if you've done this to someone else, if you're a mother or a father who's done this to their child, it's probably not something you want to think about.
Did you know about circumcision when you were a child?
No, I did not know about it because the family is Jewish, was Jewish, and all the relatives and extended family and so forth were Jewish. And as far as I knew, that's what was the way a penis should look, the way a penis did look, and that was no question about it. And I didn't even know at that time that there had been any alteration of my penis.
I cannot recall when I first became aware that I had been circumcised. It's something that is so embedded in my being that it can't even register when I became conscious of it. No, I don't recall when.
Because I have such a big family and people are always getting married and having children, there's always been circumcisions throughout my whole life that I've attended. So as far back as I can remember is the first time it entered my consciousness.
Well, as a child born to Jewish parents, I was aware of circumcision because the word bris was often used. And I remember asking, I can't remember if it was my mother or my brother, what this bris business was all about. And you know, they sort of explained that, yeah, something was taken off my genitals. But I didn't, and it was supposedly healthier to have this done. But that was about it, and I really didn't understand too much what was involved.
So I remember saying, you know, parroting that line, it's cleaner, healthier. And for the first time, sort of heard myself saying it and saw the reaction on their faces. And they practically left me out of the pub. And that was when I sort of thought, oh, yeah, I guess that does sound pretty crazy. Why do we do this? How did I end up thinking that? Should I continue to think that? And that was sort of the impetus for my looking into it.
Because I was in the company of those who were circumcised, and there is no question about that's what a Jew does or has done to him, there was not any thought about it.
And then when I was 16, I did some research. What is circumcision? What is the foreskin? And I'm like, so that's what a penis naturally looks like. That's what's supposed to be there. That makes sense. And the idea of removing it did not make sense.
So every time I had a new cousin that was born, my family would go and attend the bris ceremony. All the men would go on one side of the room, and the women would go on the other side of the room. The mother would bring the child, hand it off to usually the grandfather, who would be holding the child while the moel is circumcising them. And it sort of happens during the morning prayer session. You know, you pray a little bit, there's a little break, and then you do the circumcision, finish the prayers, and then you eat bagels and things like that afterwards to celebrate.
I should mention I was raised as an Orthodox Jew, and when I was 13 years old, my family moved to Israel to seek better religious education for myself and my siblings. I have 5 siblings. So we moved to Israel, and I was living there, and when I was 17 years old, I was given a very unusual honor of being the sandek at a cousin's bris. Now, the sandek is the person who holds the baby at the bris, and this is... it's considered a huge honor. It's usually reserved for elders, very important members of the family. But this was a small family affair, and I was given this honor of holding my cousin for his brit milah, for his circumcision. I had never been in this kind of proximity to a bris before. You know, you always go to, growing up Orthodox, you're always going to brises. But what tends to happen is there's a kind of human ring that forms around the proceedings, where people are sort of, you know, hunched up and kind of looking at what's going on, and it's kind of almost impenetrable if you're of a certain size. So children tend not to really get to the front, so you never really see the actual thing. Of course, you hear the babies crying, but that's pretty much the extent of it. So here I am, I'm 17 years old, and I'm in, I mean, not just proximity, I'm holding the baby, and the Mohel makes the blessing, and he cuts my cousin's penis, and my cousin's screaming, and he then puts his mouth on the wound on the freshly cut penis and sucks, and he comes back up and there's a little bit of blood on his beard. And I was shocked out of all kinds of, you know, I was shocked out of my sort of ignorance of this issue, basically.
My name is Miriam Pollack, and I'm a Jewish woman. And Judaism has always been a very central part of who I am. It has defined and inspired my understanding of compassion and justice and what our task in this world is, and that is to be co-creators with God and to repair this world. I've always taken that very seriously. So when my two baby boys were born, I never questioned circumcision because I love this tradition and I love the values that I have absorbed from it. And for many years after that, I could not even articulate the trauma that I felt as a mother having witnessed this rite on my babies. I didn't know how to even formulate the questions because they were in total contradiction with everything that I believed and trusted.
Those were the two worst days of my life. And I felt so tormented as a human being that I had witnessed this, that there were other people I loved in that room, and yet it was unspoken. There was no one venting or nobody speaking up for that child, and I knew I could never witness that again. And what I usually tell Jewish mothers is that there are many moms who tell me that if they have one nightmare or regret, it's that they allowed their son to be circumcised.
The mother so often leaves the decision up to the man, up to the father to make, when what the baby is expecting is that the mother will be its protector. Because babies always expect that the one in whose body I grew is my defender. And then women turn the decision over to the man saying, well, it's really his because he has a penis. What?